Maybe Merv's holding Joyce's hand again.
Yeah. I'm in no hurry to eat, Lindsay. It's porridge again.
Well, what are you doing here then? Come to decorate the place, have you?
Well, it's made up for your ugly mugglers.
Hey, where's the grub?
Oh, in my left eyeball.
Well, the cops paid you another visit last night. They've been up for old tricks, eh?
No.
She didn't know about this one.
How do you know? I could have sworn they didn't know about my pills either.
She might have.
But it didn't do her much good.
Yeah, probably just luck, that's all.
Lou, we've got to do something soon.
Don't worry.
Only this time Wyndham won't be screwing it up.
Still spouting off, eh, Lou? Good to know there's something you can rely on around here.
Oh, you're right for once, Wyndham.
Honey, I'm still going to fix your girlfriend as soon as I can arrange it.
Won't do you much good. You want the lager, you better look in your own backyard.
Nice try. I've told Lou about our little talk.
Yeah, and I don't buy it. But keep it up. I like a good laugh.
Seems to me the laugh's on you. Particularly if you haven't got the brains to work it out for yourself.
Keep it up, lard belly, and there'll be a double funeral.
Right, come on.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, look, don't worry about Lou. She's all in here.
Not entirely, love. I mean, Lexi's in hospital, you know.
She's only trying to...
Connors, Governor's office.
Oh, get out. I haven't had any breakfast yet.
Oh, you'll survive. Come on.
Hey, you can't do that. We've got a right to three meals a day.
Shut up, Kelly. Yeah, no one's asking you.
Well, then I'm making a formal protest. What do you say, girls?
Yeah.
I'll let the governor know.
Great. And I'll tell him they forgot to salt them.
Bitches, they reckon they can get away with anything. Wonder what they want Rita for.
Who cares?
We've got more important things to worry about.
What did Mrs. Morris want you for?
Still trying to pin the freak's little shake-up on me. What else?
It's true, they don't give up, do they?
Bastards are shipping me out as well.
What the hell for?
Who bloody knows? They need a reason.
Jeez,
that's tough, Ree. I wouldn't care if it was somewhere close, but you bet your life it'll be way up country.
So bad about that. I thought country prisons were easier on you.
Yeah, sure. Especially when your mates are all in town.
Oh, go on. Don't tell me they won't pay you a visit.
After all, it's not as though they've got jobs or anything to keep them here, is it?
You saying they're a pack of bludgers, Wilder?
No, of course not.
Yeah, well, you've got to remember that it's very hard to get jobs these days.
Yeah, and from what I hear, the Conquerors have got no problems. They've got easier ways of making money to work.
Listen, big corners!
Oh, g'day, Mr. Slattery. Just getting all the girls to line up for you properly. Come on, girls, line up.
Get against the wall. And yes, not another word. Oh,
she's still in hospital. Right. Oh, cooking for the
lady. You, she didn't do it.
And I say she did.
She did.
Shut up, Kelly. I was just worried about me mate Patterson, that's all.
No need. She's out of the infirmary this morning. Now, can we get on with it, please? Thank you. Laundry. Jenkins, Kelly, Wilder, Cox, Egbert, Kennedy and Murray. Kitchen. Lynn, Mai, Corbett, Balzano, Wyndham. Wyndham, what are you doing here?
What?
You were supposed to stay on kitchen duty.
Oh, no, just for breakfast and tea, Mrs.
Oh, Stattery. That's right. You're
look
on
here.
Cleaning.
Lexi can't work. She's sick.
I didn't say she was working, did I? Now move out. You've got 5 minutes to get to your work areas.
Looks like we've got a busy morning, girls.
Yeah, nothing like skinning a dingo to break the monotony.
Julie, we've got to do something quick.
Yeah.
Look, you hop along to the dorm and I'll go and find Lexi.
Yeah.
Oh, hell, I told her to stay here.
It's okay, I thought you were a screw.
Oh, it's good to see you. Listen, I know you didn't do it.
Oh, thanks, mate. But convincing Kelly's not going to be so easy.
It's awful. How can they just kill somebody without any proof?
Well, they think they got it, remember?
Still reckon it was that Wilder woman?
Oh, stake my life on it. But that's beside the point. What we got to do now is to get them off your back.
Yeah, I'll be in that.
Come on, we better get going. If the screw comes, we'll all be in trouble.
Hey, listen, maybe we could hide her somewhere till we can prove she's not the Wilder.
No! Yeah. It's too difficult. You've got to... I've thought of something. Yeah.
What? Hello?
Well, look, what I think of is crazy, but still, give us a chance to think of something better later.
I don't believe this. What are you all doing out here?
Oh, yeah, well, I had to go and get a...
Forget it. I'm not interested in stories.
Look, Mrs.
If you're not back in your work areas in 1 minute, you'll all be on a charge.
Where are we going to go now?
The toot. No. We're going to front Kelly with it right now.
You're kidding.
Oh, no. Never more serious. I'll let you know what we're doing as we go.
Better be bloody good.
And then you and Lurch grab her and bring her up here.
It'd be less messy to put her in the dryer. Someone seemed to think that'd work with Ferguson.
Yeah, but it didn't. And we want to be sure.
Well, what's the difference? She'll still cook.
But this way we get to have some fun.
So you hold her head in here, and wham, steam rains.
Grab her, Lurch.
Going somewhere?
You're not going to blow out of the plane, are you? Here, just one squeak out of you, bird brain, will be a permanent body bar. You got that?
Why don't you pick on someone your own size, Kelly?
Oh,
well, Patterson, we've been waiting for you. Ronnie Turner, keep knitting.
Leave her alone, Lou.
We voted and the bitch goes.
Not while I'm here, she doesn't.
You changed easy.
You're off your face, Kelly. I'm not the lag.
Like hell, you're lying. She's pregnant,
hey? Yeah. You want to kill my kid too?
Yeah, how'd you manage it?
How do you reckon? Bit hard to make it up, isn't it? She's 2 months gone.
Yeah, well, I say she's lying.
Oh, no. The phantom pregnancy.
After all, she is the phantom lagger. Yeah, well, I don't care what she's pulling. It doesn't change it.
Leave me alone, bitch! You hurt that baby, Lou, and you'll have the women down on you like a ton of bricks.
You remember what happened with Nora's baby?
Hell, Lou, it's a kid.
Okay, then prove it.
We wait 9 months.
All right, Patterson, prove it. Who and when?
Get out? I thought you were against laggers, Kelly.
This is different than you know it. Now start talking, Patterson.
No bloody way.
She get him into trouble, Lou.
It hasn't worried her up to now.
Get stuffed. Look, this is wasting time. Let's just ask a screw. If she's pregnant, they'll all know about it by
yeah,
now.
Yeah, Lou, I'll go and do it.
They don't know yet.
Yeah, I thought so. Come on, grab her!
No! Sister knows. Lexi had to pay her not to say anything.
Oh, pull the other one.
No, it's true. Yeah. If the screws found out, well, he'd be in heaps of trouble.
Yeah, not to mention making us suffer through tougher security.
That sounds damn fishy to me.
But you can enjoy breathing a bit longer while we check it out, Patterson.
Gee, thanks.
Come. Let's get going before Slattery comes.
You take good care of her. I'd hate anything to happen to her.
It won't. I'll make sure of that.
Well, I wonder who she had it off
with. It's never going to work.
Of course it will. Just don't be so negative.
But I couldn't even convince Sister Hall I was sick. How the hell am I going to talk her into saying I'm pregnant?
Well, you just got to, understand?
It's your only hope.
Hey, Lou, I was thinking. Look, I reckon Lexi's all wind about bribing Sister Hall. What could she give her?
3 cheers for Lurch.
Yeah, what do you say to that, Egbert? All in the Boy George posters, eh?
Lexi gave her the money from the clothes she sold.
Oh, how could she do that? She can't get her hands on
it. It's easy. You authorise somebody else to go and get it for
you. Oh, cut the crap, Egbert. Hall's too straight.
And so's Lexi. She's not the lagger.
Change the record, will you?
I think it's about time you checked it out, Lou.
You telling me how to do my job?
No, it's just that the longer Patterson's allowed to run free, the more chance she has to drop a few more notes.
Yeah. Bitch. Take over here, will you?
Oh?
And if you're lying, Bert, you'd better start saying your prayers. So what's this new geezer like?
You'll find out soon enough.
I'm wearing a bloody tractor, that office.
Well, you've only got yourself to blame.
Like hell.
Hey, get out of my stuff! Thomas, get out of here!
What about her? She's got no bloody right in here.
I'm sorry. She's sharing yourself.
Since when?
Since I authorised it.
Well, so what? She's still got no right to stuff around in my things.
No, please, I'm sorry. I really am. There was nothing to do here. I didn't think you'd mind.
Well, now you know.
Wait out in the corridor, Connors.
Glad to. Let's make sure the Lamington lady here knows the score.
The women have very little to call their own. Tends to make them very possessive.
Yes, I can see that. Don't worry. I certainly won't do it again.
Look, if you get bored, you can always apply to work.
Yes, well, I think about it. But right now, I'd rather be on my own for a while.
Well, if you change your mind, just tell an officer.
Yes, I will. Thank you.
G'day.
Heavens, Kelly, must you?
What do you want? Well, I just came to get the dirty linen.
What's over there?
Well, there's a rumour going around that Patterson's up the duff. Is that right?
Ask Patterson.
Oh, I wouldn't believe half the stuff she says. I figured you'd know.
You figured right, but what's in my files is between my patients and me.
Yeah, it's a neat setup, isn't it? You could even start up a drug trade if you wanted.
Get out.
Jeez, it was just a joke. Anyone would reckon I hit a sore spot.
Out before I put you on report.
Okay, don't get him knotted.
Somewhere I could have it off with him. Hey, what about the garden shed, eh?
Oh, shut up, Alice.
What's the matter with you?
All this talk about racing off the handyman, it's pathetic.
Oh, up yours. Don't tell me you wouldn't like to have a go. You're just too stuck up, that's all.
So?
Alice, you've got one chance of getting
you
before me, Alice, and that's
Buckley's. Would you like to stake something on that? Shut up, Alice, will you? Giving me the urits.
Oh, that'd be right. What about her?
Well, at least she's making sense.
Rotten bitches.
Just ignore them, Alice. They're only taking it out on you because they can't hurt Lexi anymore.
Yeah. Go pick on Sister Hall. It's not my fault if she backed up Patterson.
She didn't back her up, did she?
It's as good as, Wilder. Are you doubting me?
No, but I think we should have something a little more definite considering Patterson's crime.
Hall took the bribe all right. And don't worry, Patterson will get what's coming to
him. But Lexi didn't do it. And while you're fighting like this, the real lag is getting away with it.
Fool! And just shut up, I've just about had enough.
Well, you can't hurt Patterson if she's pregnant.
Don't you believe it, Jenkins. By the time I'm finished with her, she's going to wish she was dead.
I don't see how sending her to Coventry is any sort of punishment.
It'll do for starters.
We could brand her, you know, an alpha lag or
you
something.
You can't do that. You'll bring on a miscarriage.
Good thinking, Egbert. Then she won't be preggers anymore.
You do anything that could harm a baby, Kelly, and I won't stop till everybody knows about it.
Don't push your luck, Egbert.
She's got a point, Lou.
G'day, Jules. How's it going?
What are you doing here?
Playing silly buggers.
Now, you want to hear some news? I mean, everybody else knows. I thought it was about time the top dog heard.
Heard what?
Funny how you're always the last person to find out about anything around here.
Oh, you're all windy.
I mean, you know about the new governor, don't you, Lurch?
Why, governor?
Real macho bastard. Tough as nails and cold as a witch's tit.
You're kidding?
Oh, yeah, and when did all this happen?
A couple of hours ago. I reckon you didn't do us any favours getting rid of Reno. This guy's trouble.
Seen him?
Yeah. Did I ever? Thanks for nothing.
I'll believe it when I see it.
Oh, you want to know something else? I ain't going nowhere. You gov wants me to stick around. Cozy, eh?
I'm gonna keep leaving you forever.
Can't I use a pillow or something
in the showers?
I don't want a kid. I hate ankle biters.
Well, look, the way things are going. Hey, Lexi, I can give him a hug.
Huh? Huh? Look at those big baby blues, will you? She wants to keep them all to herself.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, wouldn't you?
I'd chain them to the bed and feed them oysters.
Oh, hurry up,
please. Hey, did I ever tell you the definition of the perfect man?
No.
Oh, he gives you flowers, makes passionate love to you, and at midnight he turns into a pizza.
Hey, Eggbrain, you and Porky want to be very careful who you're talking to.
Get Nick, Kelly.
And if I say she's there, that's where she stays.
I'll talk to who I like.
Anything wrong here?
Oh, no, Mrs. Slattery. Just having a friendly chat.
Sit down and get on with your meals.
Maybe you'd better sit somewhere else, eh?
Rubbish, kid. Where were you?
I just wish there was something we could do about killing.
I don't know. The sooner you get acquainted with that young fella, the better.
Oh, come on. There's got to be another way.
Oh, half an hour ago, you couldn't wait to get him in the cot.
I still do. It's a real spunk. It's not just getting preggers that I don't like.
Shh. You've got company.
Hello, is it all right if I sit down with you?
Oh, look, love, we're having a private sort of conversation at the moment. No offence.
Oh, that's all right.
Next time, eh?
Yes, yes, of course.
Hey. Name's Luke Kelly. I run things around here. This is Lurch and Eve.
Alice.
Pleased to meet you.
Better be careful talking to scum like that. You pick your nose and they'll lag to the screws.
Oh, thanks for the advice. I'd better go and sit down.
She don't look like a murderer to me.
Oh, forget her. We've got more important things to worry about. Lexi. And the rest. Your governor sounds like a real mongrel.
Well, don't worry, you got rid of the last one. He causes problems, so I'm sure you can arrange something.
Yeah, I suppose I could.
He mightn't be as easy as Reno.
That's what I love about you, Lurch. You're so cheery.
Get stuffed.
Don't you think Lou can look after us?
That's not what I said. Keep twisting me words. He's a bloke. Well, he might be tougher. That's all I meant.
Then we'll just have to get rid of him, won't we?
Settling in.
Oh, well, it's a bit hard meeting so many people all at once.
Well, I wouldn't bother about some of them. That lot over there are bad news.
Oh, I met them at lunchtime. You know, they said the same about you.
Sorry about telling you to get nicked like that. Had something to settle.
Oh, that's all right. I've noticed there's not much privacy.
No, except in the pound. Oh, that solitary. Oh. You haven't been inside before, have you?
Oh, isn't that obvious?
G'day, Jess. Feel like a game of poker?
Waiting to meet the new broom.
Sounds about as exciting as a push bike ride to Bathurst. You warmed up yet?
Oh, yes, thank you. Look, I'm sorry about... Oh.
What was all that about?
I think I said the wrong thing. When I first met her, I complained about the broken window in our cell.
Oh, Rita's all right. Tell her a good joke, you'd be your mate for life.
How do you keep a sense of humour in a place like this?
Hey, he's coming!
On your best behaviour, girls.
Ladies, I'd like you to meet the new governor, Mr. Moran.
Ladies.
Is Mrs. R coming back, Mrs. Morris?
Perhaps in a few weeks.
In the meantime, I'd like your full cooperation.
Well, we're an easy-going bunch, aren't we, girls?
Oh, yeah. Name?
Kelly. You can call me Lou if you like.
Oh, yes. The top dog. I believe you were the troublemaker behind the hunger strike.
Everyone was in it. I was just looking after the women's interests, that's all.
Well, from now on, that's going to be my job. From what I hear, you girls need looking after. Well, I'm very good at that. And if you don't believe me, our association is going to be a very unhappy one. I've been doing some reading that makes me very unhappy. About Flynn escaping, money found in cells, broken windows, hunger strikes.
Gets boring sitting around all day.
It's going to get even more boring. Mrs. Morris, have the television and radio removed from this room and any cells that might have them.
That's not fair!
If any of you want to be on a charge for insolence, just keep going the way you are. You want privileges. You earn them. You don't take them for granted. Questions?
Well, you're the one that wanted to get rid of Mrs. Reynolds.
Well, how was I supposed to know they'd give the job to that bastard?
It's going to be 10 times worse now.
I'll work something out.
Big top dog's not so smart after all.
You're in Coventry, you lagging bitch. Now you keep your mouth shut. That goes for you too. Anyone talks to her and you're all in Coventry.
Nobody tells me who I talk to.
Listen, Porky.
Seems to me like you're changing the subject.
Who asked you?
You're the one that stuffed it up, Kelly. Don't take it out on us.
Yeah, so what are you going to do about getting our television
and
radio?
Come on, ladies. Time for afternoon muster.
I'll work something out. I've got other things to do first.
Hey, Mrs. Slattery, can I go work in the kitchen? I'm sick of doing nothing.
Don't be dinner. A few weeks, well, maybe we shouldn't do anything.
Yeah, we'll end up chained to the wall being fed bread and water.
Hey, that's it.
What?
Another hunger strike. Well, it worked with Reno.
Yeah, now we're worse off than before.
Did you hear something, girls?
Ah, there's a bad smell around here.
Yeah, smells like a lager. Or a lager's friend.
Look, I think I've got an idea that might work.
But what about my idea about the hunger strike?
It's a last resort. I think I know how to turn that bulldog into a puppy.
Don't like your chances.
Oh, I'm going to throw up.
Look, I can handle men. I've had a lot of experience.
Yeah, and they all end up with a bullet through them.
What's wrong with you? I'm trying to help Lou, and all you can do is criticise. Now, do you want to help or not?
Of course I do.
Then shut up and listen.
If my idea works, it's going to be a lot easier on the women than a hunger strike.
You reckon he'll go for it?
It's worth a try. Look, I'll go and find a screw and see if I can talk to him.
Good luck.
I still don't trust her. I reckon she's trying to take over.
You worry too much. What have I got to lose?
Come on, mate, don't take all day. God, that was the best tea break I've had in years, love.
Get it while it's hot, eh?
Hey, listen, are you going to be out here again tomorrow?
No way. It's a once-only offer.
What did I do wrong?
Nothing, it's just, well... Don't worry about it.
Jeez, you give a bloke an inferiority complex, won't you?
I've got to get back.
Come on, hurry, yeah, all right.
See you later.
Hey, listen, give us a kiss for good luck.
I haven't got time.
What's your name, then?
Alice Jenkins. My friends call me Lurch.
I'll remember that.
Hi there.
My office. Now.
See you, fellas.
This will go down on your parole report. You step out of line once more, and you'll be in solitary at my pleasure.
Yes, Mr. Moran.
Mrs. Morris will take you out and you can begin punishment. Mrs. Morris.
Wait outside.
Explain why 2 garbage men and a prisoner were left unsupervised.
We were short of staff when the gatehouse rang through. Normally, it only takes a few minutes to collect the bins.
Plenty of time to drop off a parcel of drugs or weapons or indulge in little exercise with the prisoners.
It won't happen again.
You're damn right it won't. The minute you're finished with Patterson, back here and we'll go over the security arrangements in detail. That is all.
Mr. Moran, one of the prisoners would like to see you.
Who?
Eve Wilde.
Bring her in. What can I do for you?
It's rather private. Could we?
That's all right. Take a seat.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, how am I supposed to do it with this?
Should have thought of that before. Use the other hand.
I have to pretend that I like Clue and do things for her all the time. It's awful.
Then why do it?
They'd kill me. Lose the only protection I have.
So you play along.
I don't have any choice. I hate it, but...
You told this to anyone before?
Mrs. Reynolds hated me after my solicitor died. She blamed me.
What happened?
Oh, it was awful. I was so alone and afraid.
What?
He said he'd drop my case unless I...
Had sex with him?
I was so scared. I didn't know what to do.
Well, you needn't continue.
No one believes me.
You are quite an actress, Wilder.
I don't understand.
Oh, like hell. You must think I'm a real fool. I've read the reports and the newspaper articles. I know what you did to that man, and now you're trying to do it to me.
You bastard.
I'm the governor, and you're a prisoner, and I hate my time being wasted. Next time you want to see me, make sure you have a damn good reason.
Bikies. Thank God Joan's okay.
We think Connors is behind it, but it's virtually impossible to prove.
What's she like? Connors, I mean.
Didn't you meet her?
Only briefly. You see, I was taken to hospital the day she arrived.
Oh, quite a handful. Look, are you sure you want to go in there? Maybe you should wait.
No, and... no. I think now's the best time. Let's go, shall we?
Move it, Wilder.
Sorry, Joyce.
You all right?
Fine.
I'm sorry, I didn't realise.
Well, at least that's over. I wonder what it'd be like seeing her again.
Look, I think you should know she's as thick as thieves with Kelly these days.
They hated each other.
Not anymore.
At least we all now know where we stand.
It's no different to any other man. Just a matter of breaking down his resistance.
Well, did you have him eaten out of your hand or not?
Of course I did. It'd take a little longer than I thought. That's
why. Doesn't seem to me like you got nowhere.
Look, there is such a thing as subtlety. Not that I'd expect you to understand that.
All right, clever bitch. When do we get the tellies and the radios back then?
As I said, one thing at a time.
Oh, good afternoon, ladies.
Hello, Mrs. Barry. How are you?
Fine. Thanks for the card, Julie.
Oh, I'm glad you liked it. Mr. Pringle's been telling us how you're getting on. He said you nearly lost your eyesight.
Yes, fortunately that was only a temporary thing.
Bond's a wig, expensive.
Oh, fair go, Lou.
How'd you keep your comments to yourself?
It's all right, really. I know it must look a bit odd, but fortunately it's only for a short time.
When are you coming back? We've missed you.
Well,
what do you think you're doing here?
Oh, I'm Officer Barry. You must be the new...
Moran, new governor. Step outside, please.
Certainly.
A person not in uniform and not rostered for duty is a civilian. You should know that.
Yes, but I've been on sick leave and I
know all about that. Still no excuse for jeopardizing prison security by wandering around chatting with prisoners.
Jeopardizing security?
We'll talk about it in my office. I want all the women in the rec room in 5 minutes. No one's to go anywhere near their cells for any reason whatsoever. Understood?
Yes,
come with me.
That's a literal wasp.
Just keep quiet and wait.
What do you reckon, girls? We want some answers.
Hey, you don't know either.
Yeah. Stay quiet, Jenkins, and all of you. There's to be a special cell search, and that's all I
have. Oh, what?
I thought we were supposed to have rights.
Yeah, you can't have a cell search unless we're there.
Well, if you don't keep the noise down, you'll all find yourselves on a charge. Now, just shut up.
You did a great job on Moran.
Maybe he doesn't like women.
Yeah, and maybe you're losing your touch.
Hey, who are they?
Yeah, how about it, Slattery? Who are the goons?
I have to tell you once more, Kelly.
It's a bloody odds and sods.
Hey?
Sods. Special Operations Division. Had them turn the last dump I was in upside down looking for home brew. The department sent them in.
I've heard about them buggers.
Yeah, me too. They look under everything bar the paint. You can blame Lexi for riling the governor.
She lag on us again?
No, she didn't lag. It's just that the governor himself caught her with the baby's old man.
Oh, yeah, and where'd they do it? Under the reception desk?
Outside the kitchen.
Don't tell me, in the dump master.
Close. Caught her with the garbo in his truck. Been at it for weeks, haven't you, Lex?
I wondered what the stink was in here.
Oh, lucky bugger. Think she's genuine?
Of course she bloody is. I heard about her copping the charge myself.
Stuff if she is or not. She's a lagging bitch and I'm going to make her life hell. Kid or no kid.
Do a fine job, these fellas. Very thorough.
Yes, Governor. It's just that, well...
If you've got a niggle, let's have it.
Well, women do behave badly when their cells are torn apart. I mean, they feel it's a violation of their privacy.
Haven't you been getting something?
Oh, I didn't.
We've already found grass, amphetamines, and a crude attempt at a knife. It's about time we stopped them violating prison regulations.
Governor, I think I found something. Found it hidden in there.
The hell is it?
CB radio. Dug this up from underneath the mattress. I wasn't sure what it was for till Jim found the radio.
Makeshift aerial. Hung it off the bars, most likely.
Yeah, looks like it.
That more than justifies the search.
Slattery, how about let me out for a leak? I'm busted.
When the governor says so and not before.
Yeah, well, he'd better say so real soon, because it's going to take him a week to air this dump.
Double, Mrs. Slattery.
Everything's under control, Governor.
Like hell it is. I was just letting Slattery here know
that
I want...
later. Right now, I want you all to know what a successful afternoon the special operations men have had.
Oh, I thought we were supposed to be there when our cells got searched.
Wrecked, me.
Not when I call the SID boys in.
They plant dope or grog.
The SIDs don't plant anything, however... They did find some very interesting gadgets which have been responsible for the recent spate of window breakings. We'll get to that later. Right after you've all been body searched.
No! No bloody way, Jose!
We're not giving you a check through.
I'll leave you and Ratcliffe to organise it. I want all available officers in my office as soon as you've finished.
When are we getting out of here?
I just told you when you've all been body searched.
All of us, but I was body searched yesterday when I came in.
And you'll be body searched again, now.
Make you feel good boss and housewives around, does it?
Don't get smart, Connors. You and Cox are first on the list for questioning when it's all over. Take them out one at a time and nobody leaves till you're finished.
All right, who's first?
I think it's pretty obvious why I've called you all in here. There's only one way to describe security in this place at the moment, and that is sloppy. Very sloppy. The CB radio. Connors and her little helper Cox made fools of the lot of you. Not to mention setting up that little incident where one of your colleagues, Joan Ferguson, was attacked in her own home. Could have been any one of you. But fortunately, we managed to get the two of them up in solitary where they belong. But only because I brought in the Special Operations Group to do your job for you. Any comments, Mrs. Morris? Reasons why none of this stuff was discovered in previous searches?
We've been understaffed recently. We haven't always been as thorough as we would like.
I think we can all consider not being thorough behind us now. I'll be using the SODs on a regular basis and mentioning this little catch on all your service records.
Oh, that's hardly fair, Governor, as Mrs. Morris
pointed out. I'd be quite within my rights to have half of you sacked for allowing the prisoners the chance to accumulate this little lot. So just consider it a second chance. And to help make sure none of this happens again, we are going to show the prisoners we are not messing around. As from now, you will all carry truncheons while on duty.
Surely that'll only antagonise them after the cell and body searches.
It'll show them who's running this place, Mrs. Morris. Up to now, I get the distinct impression they have been. All right, that'll be all. Now, Mrs. Slattery, you will be responsible for opening the armoury and breaking out the truncheons.
Right, Governor.
Mrs. Morris.
Yes?
List of the new cell allocations.
You're not serious.
This is a recipe for disaster.
I want it done right now.
But why? It'll cause turmoil.
Ever hear the expression, divide and rule? As of now, that is exactly what we are going to do.
Those bastards are doing to Rita and Barbie.
Cat and nine tails, probably.
Knew they'd get napped for that CB sooner or later.
Oh, you mean you knew about it before Rita told us?
Yeah, watched Barbie hiding it. Wouldn't mind using it myself, except none of my friends would know that CB was ever invented.
I bet you got a kick out of talking to a fella like that, eh? Real turn on.
How can they do body searches? Oh, it's awful. We don't have to take this lying down.
Oh, is that a joke or something?
No, I'm serious. We can fight back, stand up for ourselves.
Why don't you go back and ask him for our TV? Better than watching you.
Well, shut up, I'm thinking.
Bloody hell, what's with the big stick, Mrs. M?
No, I'm going to have you beat us up now, is he?
There you go, Mrs. Morris.
All officers have been ordered to carry them. That's all there is to it.
Oh, reckons it matches your jackboots.
That's enough, Kelly.
We're the ones who've had enough.
Yeah.
When's Mr. Big going to start laying off us?
If you hadn't flaunted the rules so much, perhaps you wouldn't have found the punishments necessary. Now make sure you all read that notice.
Oh, yeah? What is it? A list of floggings?
Just read it and find out. Dorm
changes. God, he's changed just about all of us.
Oh, bloody hell.
What's the matter, now? Who's he put you in?
Kelly!
Kelly's gonna kill me.
I don't understand why he's doing it. I mean, he didn't find anything in here, did he?
Well, who cares? Kelly's gonna kill me anyway.
No, she won't. She thinks you're pregnant.
So what? That wouldn't stop her.
Well, if she does, they'll know exactly who did it.
Oh, thanks, Chook. That makes me feel a whole heap better.
No, I just meant... Well, she won't hurt you because of the other girls. Why do you think Jessie made up the baby story?
Yeah. Well, it didn't stop her belting Nora, did it?
See, I'm scared.
Terrific. You're scared and I'm moving in with Kelly.
Farewells, lady, you two.
Why are you moving us?
Sorry, Mr. Moran. She's upset. She didn't mean it, did you, Lex? It's just that we don't understand why you're doing this. I mean, you didn't find anything in here. Couldn't we stay together, please?
Why do we have rules, Patterson?
Oh, I'm sorry,
Yeah, we understand, sir, but there are exceptions to every rule. It just doesn't seem fair.
Name?
Egbert.
Why do you want to stay together?
We're mates.
She's my best friend. We're no trouble, honest.
Sorry, Egbert. No exceptions to my rules.
I should give you a hand.
What are you so happy about?
I reckon all this is a pain in the bum.
Oh, I don't know.
I reckon Connors has done me a favour.
Just think, me and Patterson are the same self.
Ah, Patterson. Rack off, Egbrain. I said rack off.
Well, I bet you think he's safe now, eh? I bet you think I'd do anything and Morn will know it was me, right?
Right.
Dom, I've got ways of hurting you haven't even dreamed of yet.
Get stuffed.
You won't know if it's me. Or a nightmare.
Aren't you forgetting something?
But that's what's so good about it. You see, I wouldn't hurt the brat. But you, oh, that's different.